we heard the side of two lawmakers from the majority and the minority on why they voted in favor of the Maharlika Investment Fund bill. House lawmakers Paul Daza and Margarita Nograles said the latest version of the bill is way better and it has enough safeguards to ensure the sovereign wealth fund will not be lost to corruption. They also assert the bill was not railroaded. Let's get another perspective as the bill heads into the Senate despite strong opposition. Greco Belgica, the former chairman of the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission, will share his take on the matter. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Katrina, and good morning to all our listeners. Thank you for having me here.
Okay, are you satisfied with the final version of the bill that the House passed in final and third reading last night?
No, I did not. I haven't read the final version. However, I've been noticing that they've been adjusting the bill according to what they hear in the news and from oppositions, which is really good. However, I've not seen the final version though.
Okay, let's talk about first the penalties. You earlier mentioned, do you think that the penalties are enough considering that you have earlier mentioned that the Philippines has yet to establish a working system or an effective accountability mechanism against corrupt politicians or corrupt officials in government?
Well, definitely the accountability system here in the Philippines is not enough. No? We see that right now. Cases are pending. So many cases are pending with the courts, with the Office of the Ombudsman. It really takes a long time before we hold people accountable. Just like people accountable with the PDAF. If you remember, 2013 pa po namin to final sa Supreme Court, 2013 namin napanalunan niyan yung Belgica ruling, pero halos wala pa napaparasahan. Well, you know, that's the problem. Holding people accountable in the Philippines is very difficult, so we really have to work on it. But putting the penalty clause there is a good gesture. However, just to put things in better perspective, as the bill evolved, I mentioned that, first of all, this is not a sovereign wealth fund. Strictly speaking, this is no longer a sovereign wealth fund. This is a Maharlika investment fund already. Firstly, because these are monies that will not come from surpluses. These are coming from deposits. Deposits, pera po ng tao ito. And I think they included PAGCOR recently, 10% of PAGCOR earnings. Ano. Pero ibig sabihin, these are deposits na isinusugal at isusugal ng gobyerno para i-invest globally. Yan po kasi ang nature ng isang sovereign wealth fund. It comes from surplus. Number two, it will be invested globally, meaning to other or to multinational companies outside the Philippines or outside your country. So, of course, the intentions of the law is very good. We are not against the intentions of the law. We are all for raising funds, raising capital, raising, strengthening the economy, bringing investments. But it is the manner by which the law or the bill intends to reach these purposes that we are, questioning so that to improve the bill. Firstly, to raise capital in investments, what our country really has to do only and has been doing all along is to issue guarantees. When you issue guarantees on projects, capital and investment flows in very quickly. And if this is the purpose of the administration and of Congress, then all they have to do is to look at the charter of the Philippine Guarantee Corporation and improve on that so that more investment can come in faster into the country. In that way, cash will not be exposed. Because the thing is, why are we using cash if we can use guarantees? Kasi we are posing and, I mean, what if the investments fail? Then you lost all the deposits. These are not even, these are savings and deposits of people from Land Bank and DPP Major, mostly, that will be lost. And that's why guarantees, the Philippine Guarantee Corporation, were started from the PhilExim Corporation, was created by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Senior.
Okay.
Specifically to help this to help bring in capital and the finance businesses in the Philippines.
Okay, Mr. Belica, I understand your point, but making use of guarantees would again revert to a different type of loan, thereby affirming the claims or reinforcing the claims of former Justice Antonio Carpio that it would make the Maharlika Investment Fund not basically a Maharlika debt fund. So would that still be feasible if the government or under the Senate version, if the MIC would actually make use of guarantees?
Exactly the point, ma'am. The Maharlika Investment Fund has ceased to become a sovereign investment fund. Dahil a sovereign investment fund done by other countries come from surpluses. Ang point ko po, ma'am, we can look at other nations who, like us, strengthen their economy or wanted to strengthen their economy. That at one point, you look at the Middle East, you look at China, you look at America. The money that they had, they invested it in the Philippines. That's the first point I'm pointing out. Why invest money outside the country when we should be investing money inside the Philippines? That's why I talked about guarantee. Now, whether the government borrows money, and it is going to borrow money today because we are in a 13 trillion peso debt because of COVID. We are going to be borrowing money, whether it be a investment fund or whether it be through guarantees, if we want to bring in capital. And that's the only thing that we can do. We will be borrowing monies. But the point that I'm raising right now is that where do we bring that money? The purpose of a sovereign wealth fund is to bring the money abroad. Now, chapsoy na po kasi itong Maharlika Investment Fund. I do not call this a sovereign wealth fund anymore because it does not qualify the elements and requirements of a sovereign or investment fund as it is written in the law. This is an investment fund, a Maharlika Investment Fund, where they will be using borrowed money to invest abroad. Now, yun nga point ko po eh, nag-pull in ka na rin lang ng pera, the much better na dito mo na i-invest para direkta pong ang epekto ng sa ekonomiya. Mm. Bigay nyo na po sa small and medium entrepreneurs natin rather than give it to multinationals who really don't need it abroad and has also same risk of losing the money, and then improving our systems. Give it to fisher folks, give it to farmers para po ma-strengthen ang ating ekonomiya. And that's how we build our surpluses kasi all other nations did it that way. Eh. No nation became powerful, strong, and economically strong by investing in other companies abroad. They first invested on themselves, strengthen their economy, strengthen their businessmen, strengthen their agricultural industries, and then that made them strong. The Middle East invested in oil, China invested on their industries and labor, America invested in agriculture. The Philippines can do the same. We can increase our investments in our agriculture, in our fishing industries, in infrastructure. This will strengthen the economy of our country inside, and then build up our surpluses. And pag marami na, similar to the idea of a sovereign wealth fund, pag nakaipon na tayo ng pera because we have a strong internal economy, then we start investing to other companies. So we are going to lose money we are losing the investments that's supposed to be here if we put it outside if we bring it outside the Philippines. That's the whole point that I'm talking about.
Quite ironic, no? President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. has been traveling frequently to get investments into the Philippines, and yet the proposed fund will actually invest it outside of the Philippines. But just to challenge that point a bit, wouldn't it be more risky for the Philippines to place its investment fund in one basket, that basket being the Philippine economy alone?
No, there's plenty of investments here, ma'am. It's not putting it in one investment. There's plenty of investment here. You're talking about SMEs. You're talking about plenty of farmers, plenty of industries to I mean, highways and roads, network. You know, the risk really is manageable. Or every risk. If we invest it in the Philippines, there will be more risk that will be mitigated rather than just putting your money outside and giving it to the Bill Gates, Elon Musk, or other multinational and big, you know, buying shares, commodities, real estate in other countries. That will be riskier because we don't hold anything outside them. We're just giving out money to their companies that they have full control. Here, if you put it here in the Philippines, and we will have more control over systems, policies, people, holding people accountable, transparency, monitoring, investing in different industries, that all these industries are just requesting for one thing, to help them with their businesses, stability. They're requesting to remove corruption, to remove red tape, and to just make businesses easier for them.
Okay, Mr. Balica, let's talk about the demeanor on how this bill was passed by the House of Representatives. The Senate minority bloc says there might be a hidden agenda with the speed which it was passed. Do you share the same view? Should this be considered as a red flag?
The congressmen would know better, pero I think they were asked to toe the line in this bill because this is really the purpose and intention of the administration is to strengthen the economy. So we're all for that, strengthening the economy and putting in investments. That's why we raised up these questions. And if this is our intention, though, it's better to, number one, use the money that you will be pulling inside. And number two, if you really want to raise investments here in the Philippines, is safer to issue to issue guarantees, because fresh funds will come in if we start issuing guarantees. If you study the nature of guarantees, ma'am, the companies will be bringing, who will receive the guarantees, will be putting in their own capital, their own money into the country for certain projects. Oh. So no cash will be exposed to the Philippines, and these are new monies that will circulate in the market, unlike pulling in funds right now, meaning these are old monies. Okay. These are, in fact, deposits nga po. Yun nga po ang risky dyan eh.
Okay.
These are deposits.
Okay, Mr. Balica, final question. Speaking of safeguarding the fund, the Senate has yet to pass a counterpart measure. What safeguards or what additional provisions do you hope to be included in that Senate measure to at least insulate the fund from misuse?
Transparency, Katrina, is really important here, no? Kasi I understand, unless it was changed last night, only 5 people will be at the helm or will be in control of this $250 billion fund. Now, that is scary, ma'am. That is very scary. You know, maybe not this administration, maybe not the people that will be holding the money in this administration. Pero what happens in the next administration? 250 billion pesos being controlled by 5 people will be very risky because it will be very untransparent or intransparent. If you remember, we rejected the pork barrel system or the PDAF in 2013, and the whole country rejected it, and the Supreme Court said and declared this unconstitutional under the Balica ruling, specifically because they have proven that a lot of the money that was given to legislators, because of PDAF, were monies that were given for legislators to conduct their projects, were wasted. And this was 25 billion pesos before every year, controlled by 300 lawmakers. Now you're talking about 250 billion pesos controlled by 5 people. That's more riskier. So the point is, similar to other investment funds and similar to other financial GOCCs we have here in the Philippines, the transactions would seem to be most probably be very secretive. Kasi 5 people nga lang po. You look at all the other GOCCs, financial GOCCs, that are present today. how many of us knows where they really really invest those funds? I mean, if it's happening to them, it happened before, then it may happen. The same thing may happen to this fund. So transparency is a critical issue here. I think there should be more people, maybe the entire Congress and public should be aware where these investments will be. Because I heard in recent interviews that some lawmakers are saying that some of these monies will be invested into the Philippines. Now that's good. That's a good change, and it's a good idea. No, so it will be better if these monies will be invested here. All of those money will be invested here in the Philippines. Then there can be we can monitor it. It can be more transparent, and the effect will be direct. But a sovereign wealth fund or a sovereign investment fund are really monies that are invested abroad. So I don't know how they will change it. I hope they change it, and you know, hindi pa naman po tapos to. That's why we're putting up all these questions so that other legislators, this time the Senate and before it reaches the President, can adjust systems to make it better. To reach their goals and purposes of strengthening this economy.
Okay. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, and we look forward to hearing more of your insights once the Senate starts its debates on its counterpart measure. That was Greco Belhica, the former chairman of the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission. Thanks, sir.